brilliant toaster. It's called, well, it's made by the Funky Appliance Company. Now, I don't know if it's actually made by them or it's just put in one of their boxes, because I'm not too sure if it says that on the box yet. It's rose gold. It's, I'll translate that for people who are watching, from Eastall. And that's rose gold. Yes, it's a bit of rose gold. Let's open the box. Oh, I'm looking forward to this. The toaster that I've got originally that does toast in 60 seconds has stopped doing toast in 60 seconds. In the sense of it does one side to a reasonably good standard and then the other side is not done at all. And it's not because the elements have broke. And it's not because of anything else. It's just stopped working properly. I don't understand how it does it. Anyway, we're not talking about that. We're talking about this one. And inside, oh look, they've made it the shape of the toaster. The Funky Appliance Company. Ensure your toaster is connected to the main power supply. Well, duh. I mean, how else is it going to work? You know, they have to do that though, because there's a lot of stupid people in the world, isn't they? Just the brand new control. Yeah, I know how to work a toaster. I'm surprised they've put that many instructions on a toaster, but we've gone in circles now, haven't we? We've reached a time in history where people are just stupid. Look at this, there's an actual instruction book for a toaster. Absolutely, we're not going to read them. And I just want to see what my toaster looks like. This is the unboxing. And I'm going to take it for a test toast as well. Oh, it looks really good. It's huge. Flipping F. Right. Make sure that's still in shot. Yes, it is. Oh, look at that! And there is the front. Don't you think that just looks brilliant? It looks 1960s futuristic, if that makes sense. Do you know what I mean? You know when you watch a film or a budget TV show set in the future? A bit like Doctor Who futuristic, doesn't it? Better take these bits of card out they've put in between the separators. Now there's another thing it says on the Amazon website. It says that this can handle Warburton's bread. Now if you're from the UK, Warburton's is a major bread company and it's quite notorious for having quite tall bread that is quite difficult to put into cheap toasters, but this one specifically calls out Warburton's suitable. Right, let's get in for a closer look, because I bet you're dying for a closer look, aren't you? It's got all your standard functions on. It's got your adjustable dials. Oh, nice clicky sound. That's very, actually quite pleasurable to do and listen to. Click your buttons for frost, if you're doing frozen bread, which sometimes I do. And I think that is a button that I'm not too sure what that's going to be. It is all metal. Here is a magnet. It's not plastic. This was £90, which is the most I think I've ever spent on a toaster, but I wanted a 4-slice toaster. After my 2-slice one has now broken that does toast in 60 seconds, because I wanted a 4-slice toaster. Oh, crumb trays. Let's have a look. It's got crumb trays. I love how it's all symmetrical as well. And I love these triangles. It's got essence of 1950s, 1960s, but a bit of 1930s at the same time. I'm struggling what decade futuristic look this is. Is it futuristic 30s, 50s or 60s? I mean, you can't really say the 40s because there's a bit of a world war thing going on. Okay, Google, who invented the toaster? Why has it gone quiet? Okay, Google, volume up. Okay, Google, who invented the toaster?
toaster was invented by Alan McMasters.
Alan McMasters invented the toaster. Now we know. And let's get some war buttons to bread in there to turn it into toast. Yes. These feel quite firm as well. These feel very good. I shall now plug it in, but not before taking off the annoying little plastic thing to protect the plug, I mean, you know. And the annoying little twisty things, which take forever to undo. Mm-mm-mm, delaying my toast, and people enjoying the video.
Undo already, there we are.
Let's plug it in. This is where it goes bang and blows up, and the video never gets uploaded. Bit of a short cable, actually. I know they do this for safety reasons, but that is quite a short cable. I don't think that's even a meter. Stretch the plug to be plugged in. There we are. We are now plugged in. I have to move this actually. That's a very short cable. I did have a little flick through the instruction book. These are actually cancel buttons, so you press them to cancel the toast. It's weird because it's triangles. You'd expect them to be the stop sign, like on a tape deck or a CD player, MP3 player, your phone. Whatever, you know, it should be a square, not a triangle. Triangle up. That's, it looks as if it's two lift going up buttons. I'm gonna get the bread in now. See what I mean about war buttons bread? It's quite tall and you put them in. It says in the comments section on Amazon that you put them in portrait way up, which is quite a funny way. I never thought of putting bread in the portrait way. That's quite funny. There we go. That's four slices because I want to see for evenness. I've already said this is £90, this toaster. It's the most I've spent on a toaster, but I wanted a good one. And I wanted something different, and I've certainly got something different so far. Let's turn it on. Oh, I don't know what number to pour it on. All the way up is number six, which I suppose is Ben. So I'm going to pour it on three. I think. Oh no, we'll put it on. Yeah, three. I mean, a lucky three. Oops. Well, there's a bit of a sound there. If you press down a bit too much, it tips forward a little bit. And has the toast gone in? Yes, it has. Don't do what I'm doing. That would be very silly. And good wide slots as well. And there we go. Oh, it does light up. Look, we've got two lighting up triangles now. And they do have a little spot above the triangle as well. It is very weird. Very weird. I'm quite intrigued. Well, I'm just going to go to the kitchen now because I totally forgot to get some butter and some peanut butter. Yeah. So I can see from the fridge. And where is the butter? Oh, I've got a new. Yes. Butter. Back. It did say in the instructions, do not leave this appliance unattended, and I just did that. I'm such a rebel. Oh yeah. And I'll need a knife as well. Spreading reasons. I need a knifey. There we go. Just get some kitchen roll. And that's twice I've left the toast unattended now. And it's still in there. It's giving the lovely aroma of new electronics smell. Now, you're supposed to really, I think, remember now from when I've bought toasters in the past, I think you're either supposed to put the toaster down once and give it a test toast first before you put bread in, otherwise it's going to taste a bit metallic. And I've not done that. But hey-ho. I'm just going to enjoy some toast in a momento. Hopefully evenly toasted. How long has this been so far? It's been about a minute and a bit, hasn't it? It's taken longer. Yes, and I can feel heat coming out. The elements don't look particularly very bright glowing. I'm really hoping that it toasts evenly for 90 quid. I'm just going to move it a bit over to the side. So I can got room for spreading my toast. Is it going to give me a jump scare when it toasts? Is it just going to go really quick? Or do you think it's just going to be a... Ooh, place your bets. No, please. What kind of jump scare are we going to have? A massive one or not at all? I love the design, obviously, because that's one of the reasons why I got it. I love the pointiness of the tursed down bits. It was either going to be this one or the quite standard but obviously good quality dual-lit toaster. But I thought, you know what, no. I want something that looks different, and this certainly looks different. Well, it's... Oh! It does them independently. Has it done evenly? Yes. Yes. Yeah. Yes. And has it done the crust evenly? Yes, it has. Oh, how happy were that? Oh, that's brilliant. A toaster that toasts. And you've no idea how rare that can be sometimes. You know when you go around to somebody else's house and you have some toast in the toaster, and if they've got a really knack toaster and you're thinking, well, what are you? Why do you earn that possession? That's just very silly, isn't it? Isn't it? And let's have a bite of toast. Got off some peanut butter on as well. Do you know what? I got comments from people who also subscribe to Food Review UK, and apparently doing this is very weird. Putting butter on toast and then putting peanut butter on top of that. But why on earth would you want dry peanut butter on toast? That's just weird. Let me know in the comment section down below, is what I'm doing really that unusual? I thought everybody did this. It makes the peanut butter more creamy and it makes it spread more evenly and easily. So I don't know what the problem is. Enough yakety yak. Yeah. Fabulous toast. I love it. I like it very much. I love the design. It toasts evenly. I'm not that hungry actually, but I'm not going to waste this toast. I might throw some out for the squirrels, or the birds, or both. Absolutely brilliant. Like it. Scrabs, thanks for watching. Bye! And it does have the Funky Toaster Company written on it.